morning students. Today we are going to learning about very very important family Euphorbiaceae. Euphorbiaceae, it is for 10 marks. Okay, the family belongs to the monosexualis, monoclimidae family. Unisexualis, the classification is monoclimidae, unisexualis and Euphorbiaceae. In this lesson we are describing about Croton banpandianum family Euphorbiaceae. So in this plant diagrams are on the board. So this is the twig and this one is male flower, this one is female flower, anther, TSF vavare, male flower floral diagram, female flower floral diagram. These are the floral formula, male and female. So this is the total diagram of the Croton banpandianum. Okay, so in this family what are the aspects we have to discuss? So those are habitat, stem, root system, stem, leaf, flower, inflorescence, flower, andrisum, gynoecium, fruit and seed. All these seed and also economic importance. All these aspects we have to discuss in detail. So this is very very important for examination point of view. We have to discuss in detail. Habitat. The first aspect of the technical description is habitat. All the plants are belongs to mesophytes. All the members of the family. Maximum they are living in mesophytic conditions. All are mesophytes. Example is Euphorbia hirta. And Philanthus niruri. Philanthus species. Okay. Maximum all and Croton. Okay, Croton. C-R-O-T-A-N, Croton. So these are the mesophytes. And in this family, xerophytes are also present. Okay, what are the xerophytic plants in this family is? So xerophytes are some species, some genus in this family. Xerophytes are Euphorbia thirukalli, Euphorbia nerifolia, Euphorbia nerifolia. Okay, and Pedilanthus. So Pedilanthus, these are the xerophytic genus plants. So these are the some examples for xerophytes. Okay, so this is habitat and the next one is habit. Okay, habit. So in this family all types of plants are present and maximum species are herbs. Okay, herbs are more in this family. So those are Croton. Okay, Croton and Pedilanthus. Okay, and Philanthus. Okay, so these are herbs. The herbs means the height is very low. Herbs are very less, nearly about 1 feet plants. Right, and shrubs. In this family, shrubs are there. So those are Jetropha species. Okay, Jetropha species. Biodiesel plant, Jetropha. Jatropha species biodiesel plants, and also ricinus, castor plant, ricinus. So these are the shrubs and the euphorbia and spiny euphorbia species. So these are the shrubs and trees are also there. Okay, trees also. What are the trees? What are the examples of trees? So example trees are Imbilica. First one is Amlar Imbilica. Okay, Imbilica is a tree. Hevia also tree. Hevia rubber plant. Hevia also tree. So this is rubber plant. Okay, rubber tree. Rubber tree. Hevia, Imbilica, and so these are the trees. Millotus. Okay, millotus also a tree. So these are the examples for trees. So what is the habit? Three types of plants in this family. So those are herbs. Maximum members are herbs and shrubs. Second one is shrubs are Jatropha, Ricinus, and Euphorbia species are genus are shrubs, and trees are Imbilica, Amla tree, and Hevia tree, rubber tree, and also Millotus philippensis. This is also a tree. These are the examples for the herbs, shrubs, and trees. Root system is all the members of the family that belongs to the dicotyledonous plant. So this is the root system is all plants have tap root system. Okay, tap root system is present in all plants of the family. And the next very important point is manhart. In the plant of manhart, it is a shrub. The roots are storage roots. The plant having storage roots. Carbohydrates are stored in the roots. Those are edible. Storage roots are storing sugars. Okay? Sugars. And those are edible. Understand? So the plant name is manhart. The storage roots are present. The storage roots are edible. Sugars are present in that roots and stem. And in the family members, the stem shows more differences, diversity in the stem. What are the differences is, in the case of all the stems of the family, maximum latex is present in all stems. The first point is latex is present in all stems, okay. So this is the most important character of the euphorbiaceae. And the next one is stem is aerial. Okay, and so latex is present in the stem. Stem is aerial. In the case of amla rubber tree, stem is woody. Okay, and all members of the family herbaceous plants. The stem is herbaceous in herbs. Okay, in the case of Jatropha, stem also woody, stem also hard. In the case of Euphorbia genus, stem is modified as a phylloclade. The stem is juicy, fleshy, and green in color, and conduct the photosynthesis. The stem is considered as a phylloclade. Leaves are modified as spines. Leaves are modified as a spines. To get rid of the drought condition, to control the transpiration rate, leaves are modified as a spines in Euphorbia species and also Pedilanthus. Pedilanthus. So these stems are modified as a phylloclade. So these are the stems. Leaves. In the case of Euphorbia, leaves are in some genus, simple leaves are present. In some genus, compound leaves are present. In some genus, deeply lobed leaves are present. In some plants, leaves are modified as a spines. In the case of Euphorbia hirta, it is a herb having simple leaves, and also Philanthus niruri, Philanthus madras pratens. These are having simple leaves. In the case of Amla tree, leaves are pinnately compound, leaf is present in Amla. In the case of Jatropha, Jatropha carcass, Jatropha gracifolia. In those plants, leaves are deeply lobed leaves in the presence of Jatropha and also castor. Okay? Castor means resinous. Okay, in the case of Euphorbia species, in the case xerophytic plants, so those are Euphorbia nerifolia. In those plants, the leaves are modified as spines, the stem is modified as a phylloclade to control the transpiration rate. So these are the different leaf variations in the family of the Euphorbiaceae. The leaves also having the latex. Leaves also having the white latex. Okay. Next one is inflorescence. In the case of inflorescence, what is inflorescence? Arrangement of flowers on the peduncle is considered as inflorescence. Different type of inflorescence is present in Euphorbiaceae, but the most of the family members are having cyathium inflorescence. It is the Euphorbiaceae family character. So this is the Euphorbiaceae family character. The cyathium is in cup-shaped inflorescence. Okay? Cup-shaped inflorescence. Cup-shaped inflorescence. So this is the characteristic feature of the Euphorbiaceae. Example is Euphorbia genus and also Pedilanthus. So these are the species having their poinsettia. So these are the species having the cyathium inflorescence. And In the case of Jatropha genus, Jatropha gracifolia, Jatropha carcass, biodiesel plant. So they having the dicarcial cyme inflorescence. In the case of ricinus, so this is castor plant. So the plant having the panicle inflorescence. In the case of croton, In the case of croton, the inflorescence is racemos, but in the case of acalypha, indica, acalypha genus, the plants possess catkin. Okay, catkin. So these are the different types of inflorescences in the Euphorbiaceae family.